Hello everybody, this is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome back to the Spyro the Dragon playthrough. In our last episode, we took on Dark Passage and Lofty Castle, the first two main levels of Dreamweavers. We now have 9,200 gems, 69 dragons, for 82% completion, and in this episode, we are going to continue our journey through Dreamweavers with the final main level. And it is in this portal right in front of us. It is now time for Haunted Towers. And it's going to be a haunting experience indeed, because this is one of the most challenging levels in the game. Definitely one of the most difficult. Anyway, we start off on this little platform. Seems simple enough, but you see that pile of armor right there? It's just a pile of scrap metal for now, but it's going to be a major threat in a couple of seconds. The wizards return. Remember the wizards from Magic Crafters? Well, they're back, and they can do this. That pile of armor outside turns into this. This is an animated pile of armor, and these guys can only be killed by one move. It's a move we don't have right now. However, if we go all the way over here, take out that Nork, we have the Flame Fairy. You guys may remember the Flame Fairies from High Caves. Well, they return here, and they are the main gimmick of this world. Haunted Towers is filled with Flame Fairies, and we're going to have to use them to our advantage in order to make any kind of meaningful progress in this stage. Because the Super Flame is the only thing that can kill those piles of armor. In my first capture card playthrough of this game, I called these guys undead knights. They're not even zombies. They're literally piles of armor animated by magic. So yeah, they're not even undead anything. So let's go ahead and do this one more time. You're going to be doing this a lot. You're going to be doing this a lot more than we did back in High Caves. You're going to be running back and forth repeatedly in order to use the Super Flame multiple times. So take out that one pile of armor that was guarding that wizard so you can get rid of him. And now let's quickly make our way through this area. I'm going to try and just blow through here as fast as I can.
Hey Spyro, all dragons know there's magic in a fairy's kiss. See what it can do to your power of flame.
Bit late to be giving me that tip, since I've already seen what the fairy's kiss can do for my flame. But anyway, we want to go all the way over here to this little castle right here. And let's wreck some stuff. Time to burn, baby! Now the thing about the armor that's already animated, killing the wizard will not kill the armor that's already active. These guys will stay active long after you've taken out the wizard, so you do have to take everything out by yourself. But we won't worry about that for now. I'm actually going to ignore most of these guys for the time being, because there is actually something we can get later on in the stage where we won't have to keep running back and forth between all the Flame Fairies. Just a little note. But yeah, this level definitely throws some challenges at us. You know, you have the enemies that need Super Flame, and we're also going to be using the Supercharge in this stage too. So this is basically High Caves for Dreamweavers. We're combining all the different special abilities in one level. Alright. Lots of doors. Where do we go first? Well, first, we have a Flame Fairy. Go ahead and use her so we can actually open all the areas. Alright, this area leads to the exit. That area leads outside. We're going to need the supercharge to get through that area. And here is a dragon.
Hold your horns. Here comes Spyro.
Patience, little one.
You'll soon have the opportunity to battle the one who matters most, Nasty Nork.
We don't need no stinking patience! Little callback to my previous playthroughs. Thought I'd throw in a little reference to them. Man, I still can't believe I'm thinking about how long ago those first two playthroughs were. Like, the first playthrough of this game I did was in 2009, and then a year later I did it again. So now, like, 5 years later, I'm revisiting it. Which, you know, did raise some eyebrows among the subscriber base, but, you know, I thought, you know, it's been a while. You know, 5 years, let's revisit this game with a fresh perspective, and I do think, myself personally, that I've had a good time revisiting this game and giving it a fresh look after 5 years. Anyway, let's go ahead and do another supercharge bit. Go all the way around the outside area like I just did. Go up that ramp and launch yourself to this special area right here. And go up the whirlwind. So yeah, pretty crazy supercharge stunt. Again, not on the level of treetops, but nothing's on the level of treetops in terms of craziness.
You've become a master of the supercharge. Great work.
72 dragons, folks. 8 more dragons and we'll have all of them. So yeah, we're definitely getting close to the end game, very much so. Anyway, I'm going to save my progress just for fun. And now we have this room. This is a room where we have to work quickly to get up the staircase. We need to take out that wizard at the very top. But what the wizard's going to do is that he's going to be animating the piles of armor. We have to very quickly kill him. If he animates that armor right there before we get to him, we can't kill him. We have to leave the room because this knight will never move. Anyway, here is probably the best part of the level. This is a very special flame fairy in a gold dress. Well, it looks more orange now, but still. This flame fairy is special. Once you get kissed by her, as long as you're in this level, this super flame is permanent. So now we don't have to worry about running back and forth. We don't have to worry about our power running out. We can go ahead and just go wild. And we are gonna go wild. It's time to take out all these guys for good. And go ahead and actually, we can now actually work on finishing off this stage. Also, you see them trying to attack me. They will actually try to bash you with their helmets, so be careful. Also, we can now flame metal containers, so pretty much everything. Basically, the super flame turns Spyro into a walking weapon of mass destruction. And we're going to use that to our advantage. First, we're going to open that giant metal container for a nice little collection of gems. And drop back down here. And we're back where we were earlier. Now I just need to figure out where I need to go from here. Well, first of all, extra life. They're really giving us a lot of extra lives in these later stages. But then again, you know, these are the more challenging later levels, so it does make sense to be a little generous with the extra lives. And now, it's time for a massacre. Although technically these guys aren't even alive, there's nothing living inside that armor, so it's not much of a massacre, but we're gonna take them all out anyway. Yeah, I had to run from you guys earlier, but now I got this nice little permanent super flame, so time to die. And it's not gonna be pleasant. God, I love doing that. Like, I love this part of the level when you finally get that permanent super flame. It is so satisfying to finally be able to just destroy everything in sight. There's just something about that that's just so satisfying. Supercharge one more time just for shits and giggles. And stop! This should be the last area we have to explore. Assuming I've done everything right up to this point, we should be just about done here. Yeah, watch out for those grenade norks. No, I don't feel like eating a grenade. High explosives are not part of a healthy, balanced diet. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. That's not how you should start the day. You should not start your day by eating a grenade. It's just not good for you. Can you imagine what all that stuff's gonna do to your large intestine? I don't even know what I'm talking about. I'm just saying funny stuff just to be funny. But anyway, that's it for Haunted Towers. We are done. The main levels of Dreamweavers are in the record books. Die! Take that guy out. Alrighty then, so let's take a look at our totals. Haunted Towers is done, only two levels left in Dreamweavers, and we'll be ready to move on. We now have 9,700 gems, 72 dragons for 86% completion, and we are going to stop here. That is a wrap on this episode of the Spyro the Dragon playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.